everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today I got something I've been waiting for a year. It's called a Tricolor Beech tree. And about a year ago, we saw one in a fabulous garden and just fell in love with it because each leaf is three different colors. And it's wonderful. It's a great tree. And we've been looking for them for a whole year. And finally today we were at a nursery, the Shady Lane Nursery in Menominee Falls, and they had one, just one, because the owner's mother took the other one and she has it in her yard. So,
well, let's go up and look at the leaf structure.
Yes, let's.
No skateboarding, please.
Okay, just look at these leaves. Aren't they fantastic? And these over here have more pink in them. So they're like a pink and a cream and a green.
Yep.
And then in the fall, they turn even brighter. So it's gonna be so exciting to see it. We're gonna put it in the front yard so we can see it every single day. Here we are ready to plant our new tree. When you're getting ready to plant something new in your yard, it's important that you walk around and decide where you want it before you just go ahead and start digging. You have to take into consideration that you'll be able to see it when you want to see it, that it'll get the proper sunlight and the amount of sunlight it needs, and that the space is big enough or small enough for that particular plant. We've learned all too often that we've planted too big a plant in too small a space, and then we spend our time trimming it because it's not fitting in the right place. And then once you get it where you think it's going to be the perfect place for it, then walk around it, go back, step back and look at it from all different angles so you can see what it will look like there. And if it doesn't look quite right, or if you don't have it turned to the best side for your viewing or for the street viewing, then this gives you a chance to change it before you've already dug the hole. And this hole is going to be extensive, so we don't want to make a mistake. And then it's a matter of seeing how big it is. Make sure that the diameter of your hole is twice as large as the diameter of the pot that it's sitting in. Make sure that when you're digging the hole into the ground that you're not going too deeply. In the past, we've maybe planted some things a little bit too deeply. We've learned over the years that you want to make sure it's exactly or maybe even a little above where the bottom of the pot is and the ground level. Better it's a little above than too far below. So once we get it out of the pot, we'll be able to show that better. But right now, we're going to be digging a hole in our grass. One last consideration, and probably one of the most important, is to make sure you call Digger's Hotline if you haven't lived in your house for as long as possible, that you know where everything is. Even if you have lived in your house, you may have forgotten, oh yeah, they brought the cable in that far, or when we had our new water line or the new gas line put in, oh yeah, we forgot it was there.
Or sprinkler system.
Or that too. We know that this corner has nothing in it except the gas line, and that gas line is 6 feet beyond where we are going to be. We have it staked out, so we know where it is. Very important thing to do, and give them about 3 days to get there. If it's not a weekend, you need about 3 days for them to do it. All right, so I'm taking the edger now, and I'm going to make the hole in the soil, in the sod, where we're going to actually be putting it in.
You want to take that out and show people that tool?
Sure. This is a really cool tool.
A great tool. I love it because you can put your foot in here and you get a lot of pressure, foot pressure.
Right.
And so, you know, it's just a matter of cutting it, well, in this case, almost 12 inches away from the container.
Yep. And it's been so dry here that it's really kind of hard.
Oh, and by tipping it back, you can raise the grass, so that's a lot easier to pull out later.
Oh, yes it is.
Plus another thing too is you can take a file, and that's kind of a corrugated edge. And what I've done is I've taken a file, you can see the shiny parts, and put an edge on this that makes it a lot easier to cut. So this side too.
Ow!
Such a faker. See how sassy she is now? I've got to tell you, viewers, I know she looks innocent all the time, but after living with her for 40, well, over 50 years now.
No.
Well, we were dating before we got married. Anyhow, she is sassy. That's all I can tell you. Don't let her demeanor fool you one bit.
Once you have your circle cut, then...
you've got to move the plant, obviously.
Oh, yeah. Well, obviously, move the plant. And then at a rummage sale, my husband found this handy-dandy sod cutter, which actually just slips right under the sod.
I think I spent a whopping $2 for it.
Yes.
If that much. It might have been a dollar. And you just want to remove the sod. You don't want to get rid of the soil.
Right.
Now I'm going to put the camera down because you know who does the hard work.
See how much I've done already? Now if you don't have a sod cutter, obviously you can use a shovel.
Or your muscles.
That too.
Who needs a gym membership when you have a garden?
Perfect. Ready to dig.
I thought you were going to do the chicken dance there.
Now we've amended the soil using aged compost, manure, peat moss, perlite. I'm going to put some azomite, which is the microbe nutrients that are missing in our soil here, and some of the regular soil that we took out of the hole. We're going to mix it all up and make a beautiful stew of. Now the fun begins because you get to actually put the tree in the hole. So first you want to roll the pot around and loosen it and hit the sides and get it all so you know that it's going to be able to come out when you tip it over. And then it's usually a two-person job to get it to come out and go right where you want it. Then you kind of twist it and turn it and make sure it's at the viewing site that you like, and you may be able to see that it's wrapped with burlap and also rope. That has to come off. At least the burlap has to be pulled back. want to see if it's actually tied on there or if it's just wrapped around. I think it's tied.
Now the burlap will decompose.
Yes.
And you don't want to disturb the root ball too badly.
Right. But you can see that the rope is actually girdling the stem a little bit, so that has to come off.
So you can see you really don't want to disturb that root ball too much more.
Yep, it's very loose. I think if you moved it around too much, it would all fall off.
Yep.
And you don't want that to happen.
Yep.
But now there is a band around here. Do you think I should take that off?
Yep.
Just cut it out. There, okay.
And now the fun begins.
Okay. Now we just need to put the rest of the soil in and water it really well. All right, we've put in some of the original soil, so now I'm just mixing it in with our concoction of manure and compost and
perlite.
Peat moss and perlite and azomite.
Now, what about watering this tree?
Well, the woman that we bought it from said, water it slowly and for a long time. Don't just come over and spray it on the top and think, oh, that's enough. Got to go seep down in, and it has to be done a couple of times a week, especially during the first year that you've planted it, especially if it's really hot out.
Well, I think we're going to have to do it every other day for the first week, and maybe the second week we'll do it maybe once every 3 days, weather permitting.
Yeah.
Now, we're also only going to put the soil in up to about 1 inch below grass level, and we want to make sure that the root ball itself is also right at grass level, because we'll be putting mulch in here,
right,
to help keep the weeds down,
right,
and keep the moisture in. I think it's going to be really pretty here. I mean, those leaves are spectacular.
A bird already tried to land in it.
Yeah. Well, you were in the hole mixing. Bird decided to land here, then saw you there and scooted over to the tree, the birch tree behind you.
I can hardly wait to see the dogs come out and think, oh my gosh, a new tree. How did that get here?
Well, this is one of those wow trees that if you're looking for something special in your yard, this is one to talk about. Again, it's pretty hardy for cold climate. In fact, it likes cold climate. So again, this is a tricolor European beech. Not the beech you swim at. The double E kind.
We wanted to just give one last check to make sure that we had it planted at the right level. So the root ball is right here and the grass level is right here. So it's not too deep, it's actually perfect. Then we'll be putting the mulch around it. We'll keep the mulch away from the trunk of the tree. Whenever you put mulch down around any plant, don't let the mulch go right up to the plant. They don't like that. You're asking for trouble with diseases and insects. So we'll water this in really well. We'll get some mulch and put it around, and it'll be absolutely beautiful.
Yes, it's already beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Nice addition to the Wisconsin garden.
Yes. If you enjoyed this video and you learned something and you would enjoy maybe thinking about getting a tricolor beech for yourself, and you'd like to support the Wisconsin Garden Blog, please give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. We appreciate it, and thank you for all your comments and questions. We'd like to know if you have something interesting growing in your yard that you'd like to share with everybody. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe.
So, you want to give me a bath while you water the tree?
No, it doesn't want your sweat all over it.
Well, it's already got my sweat.
Be glad you have hot water.
I do. Thank you for all of those of you who were concerned when we didn't have water, hot water for a week. We have it back. I can shower again.
Yay!
Connect with us on YouTube.